Ufemi Uweksu. That's my true name.
I'll remember it. Guess we're doing this.
What? Why does it have to come to this? You both want to save the same person!
Sometimes, you just have to fight these things out.
Yeah.
I ain't holding back, Aizen. Good. If you want...
No mercy!
Wounds that will hurt!
Threat.
You got that right!
Don't even try it! Yeah, I'm not dead yet, at least.
Thank you for saving me.
I should be thanking you. I'm just glad you're not hurt.
Me?
That's right, kid. Nothing would hurt Theodora more than to harm a child.
Theodora...
The thing is, even when a child's lost their parents, their family, even when despair fills their heart, if you hold their hand, they'll squeeze back. Those hands, frozen cold from fear and insecurity, will start to feel warmth again. That warmth, a tiny spark deep within, can rekindle their feeling of being alive, because they possess the determination to keep on living. That's why Theodora never turned her back or gave up on a child. She was more passionate about life than anyone I've ever known.
And that's why you're protecting her.
Just how long do you plan on cleaning up after that dragon?
She's Theodora.
Once a Moloch becomes a dragon, there's no turning back.
And you think that gives you the right to kill her?
You talk like you have such noble intentions, but you're not fooling anyone. You just want to lift your Reaper's curse.
I'm not the one who's cursed.
You're telling me there's some other Reaper out there?
Don't answer a question with another question.
Shut the hell up! You're all talk and no fight. You're a damn coward. That's all you are. In the future, if you try to lay even a finger on Theodora, well, there's going to be hell to pay.
Give me hell if you like, but think about one thing first. Think about what she taught you about living, and consider what it really means to be alive.
This. I get that their creeds mean a lot to them both, but isn't that all the more reason for them to try to understand each other? But instead, they resort to fighting without even listening to each other first. How can they be like this?
Yeah, I don't want them to fight either. But there's something else I can't figure out.
Is it about why Aizen's so intent on killing that dragon?
That's part of it. What I can't figure out is what he means when he says that killing can also save someone, and how he's not the one with the curse.
Maybe he feels pity for Theodora, and how she's doomed to keep on living as a dragon.
Yeah. What does it really mean to live?
This topic sure got deep fast.
Yeah.
Good luck. The boss has a request for you.
Not a message, but a request.
A Whitehorn dragon has been showing up in the Aldina Plains. The boss wants you to kill it.
Since when did the Bloodwings become agents of justice? Interested in protecting the world from dragons?
Hey, we're not out to save the world. This is just to put an end to Zavid's madness.
Did Zavid do something in particular?
He's been harassing exorcists, trying to get more information on that dragon. That's got the Abbey on alert, which makes trouble for us. Our spies in the Abbey can't operate under these conditions.
And that's where we come in. Does that mean Zavid is in the Aldina Plains too?
Got it in one. Just be careful. Zavid and that dragon are even more agitated than usual.
Let's go.
Are you gonna fight Zavid again?
The time has come.
Dragon!
This takes me back. I remember the first time I tried to talk to you. You smacked me pretty good then, too. Man, that hurts. You sure don't know how to hold back, do you?
Zavid! Aizen, why?
Just watch.
What?
So, you're just waiting for me to die so you can help yourself to her heart. Is that it? Sorry, but that's not happening. I'm not dying here, and I won't let you kill her.
I'll decide what I do, Zavid.
Fine! Then I'm deciding to help Zavid, no matter what you tell me, Aizen! Zavid!
This dragon wouldn't hesitate to attack a child, or the man who risks his own life to protect it. Tell me, Zavid, who is this Whitehorn dragon? You said that your creed was to never give up on living, no matter what may happen. If you really believe that, would you say that you're living right now? Because to me, you don't look like someone truly living.
The hell are you saying?
I understand now. Aizen really isn't the one who's cursed. By killing Theodora, he's actually saving...
It's time to lift this curse.
To save Zavid and Theodora!
Watch out for the malevolence, Lockie said.
You too, Aizen.
Killing Flash!
But I'm this close.
I won't miss! Form Zero! Thunder! Double Twist! Shooting Star! Double Hit! Hold up! Form it! Form it!
Stay back.
Get away from her! If you kill her, if you kill Theodora, I'll never forgive you, Aizen!
I know.
Aizen, how could you? What? Malevolence!
Aizen!
Stay back! This is...
Aizen! Zavid!
No! It'll get you too!
But Velvet, just look at them!
It's that fire again.
Amazing, it can extinguish that much malevolence.
But the dragon... Please, turn back to normal! I can do it! With this flame! Zavid!
It's over. Thank you.
Why didn't you break your Reaper's curse?
What? Did you want me to eat its heart?
Don't answer a question with another question.
The Reaper's curse is mine to bear alone. The danger of becoming a dragon, however, is a curse upon all Malakim.
All that malevolence. It's going to take its toll on you, too.
Yeah, I can already feel it starting. It won't be long before I wind up like her.
You'll have to leave your pirate buddies before things turn ugly.
I'm the first mate on Ifrid's ship, so to be honest, it's probably just as well. I'd rather end up a dragon than have this curse hijack my ship and my life anymore. But I do fear one thing. I'm afraid that when I turn into a dragon, I could end up hurting the very people I want to protect.
Theodora couldn't even recognize anyone she loved anymore. You saved her, Aizen. By killing her. Before all this, Theodora was a kind woman. She never wanted to hurt people, and she loved more deeply than anyone I've ever known.
Yeah.
Sometimes to kill someone is to save them. You have someone you're trying to protect too, don't you?
My little sister.
What's she like?
She's like an early blooming flower. Wise for her age. She's got it all together. Sometimes has to treat me like I'm the kid. She cries too easily. But deep down, she's so strong.
Sounds like someone I'd like to get to know better. Who knows? Maybe I'll even marry her.
Zavid!
Don't you worry. I won't make a move until I've killed you.
Zavid, what are you saying?
Consider it revenge for Theodora. I'll be the one who finally puts you out of your misery. But I'll only kill you once you've stopped being yourself. Only then.
You sure?
Yeah. I swear by my true name, Filk Zadea. Zavid the Oathkeeper.
Ufemiu Wexu. That's my true name.
I'll remember it.
Is there really no other way? There must be something besides turning into a dragon or getting yourself killed, right?
In the end, what matters isn't whether we get killed or not. It's whether we can take control over the direction of our own lives.
That's what it means to really be alive.
That sounds sad and hard. But I understand.
And I'm going to live life in my own way, too.
Well then, I hope we'll see each other again.
Where are you going?
Wherever the wind takes me.